next ride down. Reactivity towards acid. CO plus N2 is producer gas. Reactivity towards acid. See, carbon has different reaction with hot and concentrated acid and with dilute acid. Okay? Cooled and dilute. Right on. Carbon reacts with hot concentrated H2SO4. And get oxidized into CO2. And forms sulfur dioxide gas. SO2 it forms. Okay, reaction right down. C plus H2SO4 gives CO2 plus SO2 plus H2. Okay. Write down next. Carbon reacts with hot dilute acid. And forms a brown colored substance. Which is known as artificial tannin. T-A-N-N-I-N. Not that important. Thing is a color, right? With dilute, it forms brown colored complex. That is important. Okay, name is not important. If you use HNO3, concentrated HNO3, then what gas evolves in this? NO2, right? H2SO4 gives SO2, HNO3 gives NO2, right? Next one you write down.
What's the chemical formula?
It's, see, when you have an carbon with, suppose we are using HNO3, dilute HNO3, means water is there. So this will be a complex of water and there is a hydrocarbon will get. We'll have a compound of carbon and hydrogen here. Depends upon what is the amount of HNO3 you are taking. So it may be any hydrocarbon of this. With water, it forms a complex compound. That complex is tannin, artificial tannin. Okay, next write down. Carbides. Now we have discussed the preparation of these things, alkanes, alkynes, by what method? By hydrolysis of certain carbides.
Tomorrow you guys have class?
No, sir.
No. Carbides, write down. Carbon when heated with metals, forms carbides. For example, beryllium with carbon 2C gives BeC2. Beryllium with carbon BeC2, very common form of carbide. Another one is Mn plus C, manganese plus carbon, it forms Mn3C, manganese carbide. Mn3C, manganese carbides. Okay. There are certain oxides, write down. Hydroxides, phosphates and sulfates. Which reacts with or heated with carbon to form carbides. One example we'll write down. Certain oxides, write on magnesium oxide, MgO. MgO plus 3C gives MgC2 plus CO, carbon monoxide. done MgC2 plus 3C. Sulphosphates, you write down calcium phosphate, Ca3PO4 whole twice. Ca3PO42 plus carbon 14C forms calcium carbide CaC2 plus phosphorus plus carbon monoxide evolves. Carbon monoxide CO. CaC2 plus phosphorus plus CO, carbon monoxide evolves. Next one, sulfate BaSO4. Hydrolysis of what? CaC2.
CaC3PO4
twice. Ethane form.
So you're getting calcium carbide.
Then hydrolysis of this will
do. Yeah.
So, but yes. The other method which you use to prepare calcium carbide requires high temperature. So this is happening at normal.
No, it's calcium carbide is forming. And then after hydrolysis of.
So even calcium carbide is prepared by heating it to like 2000 degrees
Celsius.
So isn't this very easy compared to that?
No, you said the preparation of ethyne.
So for that we need calcium carbide. So
correct.
That method we heat it to a very high temperature, and then here it's just happening so easy.
With this method also you can prepare. No, see, it's like it's happening so easy. You are looking at it, right? But how? See, it looks like easy, right? But
so
actually,
it's happening at like a lower temperature.
No, it's not. The temperature is not mentioned. You never know what is happening. Temperature is not mentioned. It's not mentioned lower or higher temperature. See, thing is, easy or tough, it depends upon what reaction, what energy it requires. How the reaction is behaving towards the heat. Whether the heat is coming out or getting, you know, consumed into this. So if heat comes out is very high, what is the rate? There are many factors. What is the rate of the reaction? The rate of the reaction is also very fast. It's very difficult to control the reaction. That's why in laboratory we don't use this method for the preparation of calcium carbide. Reason can be anything. Like I said, high heat may involve, rate is very fast, you cannot control the reaction. Many things is possible. So we cannot say that. Okay, that's the thing. But yes, whether you can prepare or not, by this method we can prepare calcium carbide. Okay.
So, but the temperature, is it less than that or is it just...
See, here, the very high temperature is not required. For this reaction, very high temperature is not required. Otherwise, it would have mentioned, at high temperature it gives this. Okay? Next, write on sulfate, yeah. Right? BaSO4 plus carbon, C.
Hydroxide.
I'll give. Abhi maine kya kiya? Phosphite kar liya. MgO got oxide कर लिया, hydroxide कर लिया, ठीक है? Sulfate है, BaSO4 plus 2C gives BaC2 plus SO2 plus O2. BaC2 plus SO2 plus O2. What is left?
Hydroxide
क्या ना? MgOH whole twice नहीं क्या? MgOH whole twice plus 4C gives MgC2 H2O2. Write down. These carbides are reducing in nature. Right on. Alkali metal carbides are soft in nature. But the other carbides are hard. Silicon ka structure is given in NCRT?
Yes, sir.
Okay. One more compound you write down, then we'll see. Carbonic acid. What is the formula of carbonic acid?
H2CO.
Weak or strong acid?
It's a
weak acid. Right? Inorganic but weak acid. H2CO3. Okay, write down. It is prepared by the reaction of CO2. CO2. And water, reversible reaction. CO2 plus water gives H2CO3. And hence, the anhydride of H2CO3 is what? Carbon dioxide. We also call it as carbonic hydride. CO2. CO2 is the carbonic anhydride of H2CO3. Okay, it is a dibasic acid, H2CO3. dibasic acid, and its conjugate base, and its conjugate base is stable because of what kind of resonance is there? No, that is conjugation. Its conjugate base is stable by equal resonance. CO3 2 minus is what? CO3 2 minus shows equal resonance, right? So its conjugate base is highly stable because of equal resonance, and hence it is a good acid. However, it is weaker than all those H2SO4, HNO3, and CO4. Okay, next, write down compounds of silicon. Compounds of silicon. First one, SiCl4 carbon tetrachloride. It is prepared by passing dry chlorine, dry Cl2, over heated silicon. It's Si plus 2Cl2. Water we don't use here because then it forms hydroxide. Okay. Dry Cl2 plus 2Cl2, it forms SiCl4. Second method of preparation is by heating magnesium silicide, MgSi. Magnesium silicide with Cl2. It forms SiCl4 plus Mg. Silicide.
So heating
magnesium silicide. Yes. Write down. SiCl4 easily hydrolyzed to form silicic acid. SiLiCic. Silicic acid. SiLiCic. Silicic acid. The formula is SiOH. On hydrolysis, it gives SiOH. Okay. Write down. Silicon has vacant d orbital. Vacant d orbital. And hence it accepts the lone pair of electron from water. And releases H plus ion. So basically, you see SiCl4 has a tetrahedral structure, right? Cl, 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 and Cl. Now with water, what happens? H2O, it has vacant d orbital and accepts one pair of electron from this. And then what happens? This H plus and this Cl minus comes out, forms HCl. We'll get what? SiCl3OH. Similarly, the same reaction, we have three more times. Okay, one by one. So we are using 4 moles of this total, and eventually you'll end up getting SiOH4. For how many moles of HCl? 3 moles of HCl here. Total 4, 2 plus 1 HCl. Okay. One last reaction in this write-down. SiCl4 goes under reduction reaction with hydrogen. Goes under reduction reaction with hydrogen and forms silicon, pure silicon. So SiCl4 plus H2 gives Si plus HCl. Si plus HCl. Okay, next compound write down, carborundum. SiC, carborundum.
This is the most common.
carbon and SiC, silicon carbide. It is obtained when a mixture of silica. It is obtained when a mixture of silica and carbon is strongly heated. Reaction is write down SiO2 plus C gives SiC plus CO. SiC plus CO. Write down next properties. Pure carborundum is colorless. Is colorless. Very hard. But less than hardness is less than diamond. But it is also very hard in nature. Chemically inert. The structure of carborundum is similar to that of diamond. Okay, very hard, chemically inert. Even it is not attacked by HF also. HF is a very strong oxidizing agent, but it is not getting attacked by HF. The structure is similar to that of diamond.
Does it physically also look like a diamond?
Not exactly. It is not. No, it does not look like diamond. But its structure is same. It is not that shiny.
Why is it inert? See, SiC, if you see the entire structure.
So the entire structure is stable at normal condition. This normal condition we are talking about. So the electron present in the shell, which is bonded with the carbon atom, it does not go to the excited state in normal condition. Right? That's why it does not react easily. But again, if you use very high heat here or very high temperature, then maybe some excitation is possible in the reaction process. Okay. So next, write down. Next, one last one. Silanes. Write down. These are the hydrides of silicon. Hydrides of silicon are silanes.
How is the structure of copper?
It looks like diamond only. Diamond type structure we have now SiC. So you see, silicon will be there in the center,
and carbon will be like this.
And it is associated molecule, so it is associated with another silicon atom. The entire crystal will be like this. Okay. So silanes are what? These are the hydrides of silicon. It may exist as a straight chain or branch chain. It is prepared by, right now, it is prepared by the acid hydrolysis of magnesium silicide. Magnesium silicide. Which gives a mixture of silanes. Miss, see the reaction. Mg2Si, when reacts with HCl, it forms SiH4. It can also form Si2H6, Si3H8, like that. SiH4, Si2H6, Si3H8, and so on. Mixture of silanes we get here, which can be separated by fractional distillation, okay, which is not there in our syllabus. Little bit we'll discuss in solution chapter what is distillation and fractional distillation. So this can be separated by that. So, but since we are getting mixture of compounds here, then this method is not that useful, okay. So other method we use for the preparation of silanes, and that is, in this, write down, magnesium silicide Mg2Si is allowed to react with ammonium chloride in presence of liquid NH3. Mg2Si plus NH4Cl, liquid NH3, it gives you SiH4, pure form of this. SiH4, some other compounds also get ammonia. This is the pure form of this. Another method of preparation you write down, by the reduction of silicon halides, that is SiCl4 with AlCl4, lithium, aluminium, hydride. SiCl4 reacts with AlCl4 in presence of ether. Ether is a solvent here. Okay, it forms as AlCl plus AlCl3 plus SiH4. This reaction is important. We'll get pure form of silicon hydride. Okay. Okay, fine. So there are few structure of silicates. Okay. Structure of silicates. For that, I'll share the notes with you. Okay. Just you need to go through the structure and memorize that. Sometimes they ask in the exam, but not that important. Okay. Silicon, overall, silicon is not important in this chapter. Little bit of structure of silicon. Okay, guys. I'll share the notes with you. Thank you.